This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about coterminal angles. So I've drawn a circle here, and I've indicated the first, second, third, and fourth quadrants. And let's say I want to draw an angle in standard position in this circle. Let's say I want an 82-degree angle. So I start over here, going to go counterclockwise. I end up in the first quadrant, and we'll say that this angle here is 82 degrees. Now let's say that from that point where I ended up, I go around one complete circumference around that circle, and I end up in exactly the same place where I did before. So what I've done is I've taken the 82 degrees and I've added 360 degrees more. That's that one trip around the circle. And I end up with a new angle that has a measure of 442 degrees. Now, since both of these angles, the 82 degrees and the 442 degrees, ended up in exactly the same place, since they terminated in the same place, we say that these two angles are coterminal. Now, given all this, we could look at the two angles, just the measures of the two angles, 442 degrees and 82 degrees. And even if we didn't have a picture showing what had happened, we could tell if they were coterminal. All we would have to do is subtract one of those measurements from the other. It's like 442 minus 82. We get a 360. And if the result we get is 360 or any positive or negative multiple of 360, then the angles are coterminal. Okay? So you just subtract one measure from the other, see if what you get is a multiple of 360. Let's try some examples to make sure this will work. Okay, so let's say we're given 110 degrees and 830 degrees as the two angles we have. We want to know if they're coterminal. I'll take the bigger one, 830 degrees, and subtract the smaller one, that's 110 degrees, and I end up with 720 degrees. 720 degrees is 2 times 360 degrees. It's a multiple of 360. So these two angles that I had are coterminal. To see that visually, I'll start in the standard position, and I'll draw an angle. This will terminate in the second quadrant. I'll draw an angle of 110 degrees. And then, since there's a 720 degree difference, I would go around the circle one time, that's 360 degrees, and a second time, that's 720 degrees more, and I would end up in the same place as before at 830 degrees. Okay? This will also work with negative angles. Let's say we've got one positive and one negative. Maybe we have 265 degrees and negative 95 degrees. Okay, so I'll subtract one from the other. 265 degrees minus negative 95 degrees. That's the same as 265 degrees plus 95 degrees. We add those together, we get 360 degrees. So these two angles are coterminal. Visually, what we have is something like this. The positive angle went around counterclockwise through the first and second quadrants, ended up almost at the end of the third quadrant. So there's 265 degrees. The negative angle started in the standard position and went through the fourth quadrant, ended up in the third quadrant, exactly where the 265 degree angle is. Okay? And let's do one with a radian measure. Now, when we deal with radians, it's going to be exactly the same thing, except instead of talking about 360 degrees and multiples of 360, we'll talk about 2 pi and multiples of 2 pi. So maybe we've got an angle that's pi over 2 and another one that's 5 pi over 2. We want to know if they're coterminal. So I'll take that 5 pi over 2, subtract pi over 2. This is like 1 pi over 2. So 5 pi minus 1 pi is 4 pi over 2, and that reduces down to 2 pi. So those two angles would also be coterminal. Visually, the pi over 2 angle started in the standard position and went to the border between the first and second quadrants. So that's pi over 2. The second angle went around the circle, 2 pi, and finished up in exactly the same place, coterminal with the first one. Okay, so that's all there is to it. Take care. I'll see you next time.